New products from Nokia and BlackBerry, an updated version of Windows, and our robot that'll keep your plants alive. Guess which one I'm most excited about? I'm Callie Lewis. Welcome to GeekBeat. This episode of GeekBeat TV is brought to you by The Ben Heck Show. Our friends at crackberry.com live blogged BlackBerry's announcement yesterday of the Q5. They're also doing all sorts of live streaming from the show at crackberry.com/live. The Q5 is a stripped-down version of the Q10, primarily focused on emerging markets like India and Indonesia. In addition to the lower price and slightly lower specs than the Q10, this entry version to their line also comes in colors other than black, like red, pink, and white.
Woo. Pink, all right, just for you.
Pink, just for me. Yeah, you know how I like my pink gadgets. No word on when they'll be available in the U.S., though, unfortunately. It's a different story over in Nokia land, where the Lumia 925 is kicking off in the U.K. and Europe in June, and in the U.S. on the T-Mobile network soon after that. The 925 has a 4.5-inch AMOLED display, an 8.75-megapixel lens with image stabilization, as well as improved performance in bright sunlight, and new photo software called Smart Camera that includes more storage and sharing options. It's running on a dual-core 1.5 gigahertz chip and has 1 gigabyte of RAM. 1 gigabyte of RAM, I pluralized that. Why would I do that? I don't know. It doesn't have built-in wireless charging, unfortunately, but has contacts if you'd like to use a cover for that purpose. A link to WP Central's hands-on is at geekbeat.tv/646. Microsoft continues to leak more news about Windows Blue, so if you've been wondering, it will be officially called Windows 8.1 when it launches in preview mode on June 26th, just ahead of an official rollout on, well, Microsoft isn't saying just yet. But when it is launched, you should see it on RT and the full version. How would you like a gadget that automatically gives your dog a treat? I mean, why should you be the one to do that? Well, Ben Heck is coming to your rescue. He's working on creating that. Man, that guy is a modding wizard. He's crazy. If you ever want to be inspired to do some stuff yourself or just enjoy watching people like him do their thing and enjoy it from afar, be sure to check out The Ben Heck Show. And you can enter to win one of his creations at element14.com/TBHS. Good luck. And you know I don't have any of that good luck when it comes to houseplants. So I'm interested to see how Rutgers University IndiPlant project turns out. This is basically a mashup of an Arduino board, light and moisture sensors, and Roomba-like technology that'll allow houseplants to automatically move out of shadows and into sunlight when they need nourishment, and out of heat to shade when they need protection from the sun, all by themselves. It's like a two-year-old kid. They just take care of themselves, right? Did you guys hear about Vlogger Fair yet? John P. and I will be in Seattle to attend it on June 8th and 9th. Our friend Chris Perillo is putting it on, and it'll be a place you can learn from and meet all of your favorite people online, but offline. If you haven't signed up yet, use discount code GeekBeat. It'll give you $15 off. It'll be so much fun. I hope to see you there. We also have meetups in Chicago and New York coming up. Chicago is this weekend. We'll be shooting at the LRS booth at the National Restaurant Association show, learning about all sorts of cool technology that goes into the food industry. So look for those videos on social media and YouTube and the GeekBeat feed all over the place. Don't forget. I'm gonna be so hungry after this. Are you hungry yet? I'm Callie Lewis, bye. I'm gonna go get some food. It doesn't sound like a medicine. What? Where is you? I don't know. What to do with you, Dave? Yo, Scott. Yo, what's up?
That's right, we're cool.
I didn't say anything.